Another brush that I want to create is a grass brush. I have a few sprites prepared with the FilterForge software. So let's open File Importer and import them first. Let's actually go over here. Okay, so here I have the textures, the albedo texture with transparency and normal texture for the grass tufts. So let's create a new blank material using the developer tooltip. Create new material. I'm going to use the metallic workflow. So let's first assign the albedo up. So I'm going to grab it and drop it over albedo texture. Let's also assign the normal map. Let's drop it over here. And because it's using solid rendering, I need to switch it to alpha clipping. Cut out, there we go. Okay, so now that I have the material ready, actually let me also adjust the shininess first, so the metallicity, it shouldn't be metallic. But let's make it a little bit more smooth to give it a little of shine. So now let's start working on the brush itself. So I'm going to teleport over here. I have a bunch of brushes here, but I'm going to grab a copy of this basic one because it's using the default settings. So let's actually tip it into the material. However, as you see, this doesn't create the necessary result. Because you can see that every single billboard is using all 8 of the pictures that I have. So what I need to do is I need to define atlas information so the tooltip knows how many pictures there are, how many individual sprites. So I'm going to grab the developer tooltip, I'm going to select it and open inspector. Now I'm going to look at the PBS metallic, and the material sits right on this orb. You can see PBS metallic, you can see the textures that we've assigned. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to attach another component. I'm going to go to rendering. And there is Atlas Info. So let's select this. Okay, so it's there at the bottom. So as you can see, there's some information. So there's the grid size. So that is 8x8. Sorry, 3x3. I'm getting a little bit ahead. And by default, it assumes that all of the slots in the grid are using an image. But there is one missing, so I'm going to explicitly say that there's 8 pictures. So it's going to use all these and ignore this one. So now when I drop this into, you can see now it automatically picks up sprites. As you can see, this is pretty messy. This is not the way I want the geometry to be created. So I'm going to open inspector for the brush itself. And let's have a look. The component. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do, you can see it randomly assigns rotation in all three axes, but I only want the vertical axis, so I'm going to zero out all these. Now you can see it only rotates in the around the horizontal vertical axis. So another thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change the pivot. So it's so I want the bottom of the tooth to be at the tip of the controller. So this is in normalized coordinates, so it's relative to the size of the billboard. So I'm going to go minus 0.5, so half the height of the billboard. As you can see, this immediately affects. However, also it cycles between the minimum and maximum size, and the minimum size is 0, which is too small for this brush, so I'm going to redefine this as well. So there you can see there is the minimum. Oh, it's actually not 0, but it's my small value. So let's actually zero it out and type in some nicer number. So let's say the biggest is going to be 0.1, and the smallest is going to be half of that, so 0.5. Should be good enough to start. So there we go. Select all. And let's try this out. And this is starting to look much, much better. However, there's still another issue. You can see there's the position is randomized. So what I want to do is I want to set because by default the brush spawns the part of the billboards in a random position within a certain radius. So there is particle spawn radius. I'm going to set it to 0. So they are going to be spawned directly where I put them. So let's move this out of the side. Let's make it actually a bit bigger. Now, as you can see, this is much, much, much better brush. It's creating quite nice grass. Yeah, there we go. This is pretty good. You can play with some other settings like the brush rate. For example, this is pretty dense grass, and it's creating a lot of geometry, so you couldn't afford to have too much of this in the scene. And also, it's not working completely as I want. So what I'm going to do, there is a property called there is where is it? A stroke point rate, and that's essentially how many billboards are spawned per unit of length of stroke. So let's decrease that to, let's say, 20. Let's try it again. You can see this is giving me much finer control, so I can create much less dense grass. Okay, this is pretty good. Another thing is, let's put it over here. You can see this is looking actually quite nice. Another thing, it's using the rotation of the brush, and so if I start drawing and I tilt the brush, you can see it affects it. If you don't want this, you might want to give the artist or yourself the control over this, but if you don't want this, you can go to the rotation space and set this to null, so it will use the workspace. And now, no matter how I rotate the brush, it will always stay vertical. However, I like having a little bit of control over that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set it back. So the rotation space was the brush itself. So let's grab reference to it and let's assign it back. So now I can make this grass ball. That's pretty nice looking. Well, nice, relatively speaking. So essentially, that's the way you create a grass brush in NIOS.